So look at this sculpture. So it is a fractal. It is a fractal based on this hexagonal bipyramid. But what is interesting about this is that it has square projections from each of its faces. That is, so you can find it just a square, and so it has square projections in six ways. In six ways, and in each of them, so you have 9 × 9 grid. This is just a grid of a Sudoku puzzle, and it is colored with 9 colors so that it has Sudoku solution patterns. That is, all the columns and rows and blocks have all the 9 colors in all of the 6 projections. And so I'll leave it in the exhibition room of the third floor, so please look at it. And my talk is about its generalization to 4-dimensional case. And so it is a joint work with Yasuyuki Tsukamoto. And so this sculpture has a bit long story, but so this is reassembled. This portable one is reassembled by Tsukamoto-kun rather recently. And yes, imaginary cube. Imaginary cube is an object so which has 3 orthogonal square projections, just like a cube. And a double imaginary cube is an imaginary cube of 2 cubes. Therefore, it has 6 square projections. And this polyhedron and this fractal are the double imaginary cubes. And double imaginary cube polytopes are only this polyhedron and its variants. And we can generalize this notion of imaginary cube to higher dimensional. And imaginary 4 cube is a 4-dimensional object, so which has 4 orthogonal cubic projections. And a double imaginary 4 cube is an object with 8 cubic projections. And the 16th cell, is a unique double imaginary 4 cube polytope. And there is no such object in higher dimension. So therefore, so for the generalization of this, the 16th cell is the unique possibility. And I love 16th cell. So it is a cross polytope in that all the vertices are on the axis of coordinate, just like a regular octahedron. And also it is a double imaginary cube. And when it is projected from each of its facets, it is projected to a cube, just like this hexagonal bipyramid. And also, so it is very similar to regular tetrahedron in that the set of vertices is every other vertices of a hypercube. And therefore, so a regular octahedron and hexagonal bipyramid and regular tetrahedron has these beautiful properties. But a 16th cell has all of these properties, and I like it very much. And this is a sculpture yesterday, and so it is very related to 16th cell. And because a 16th cell is, I hope, yes. So it is very similar to tetrahedron, so we can make a fractal just like a Sierpinski tetrahedron. And so we consider its third level approximation of the fractal. It is composed of 512 pieces, and it is projected to a cube. And we consider three-dimensional Sudoku problems based on this grid. The first one is to assign 64 colors so that every 8 × 8 planes and every 4 × 4 × 4 block contain all the 64 colors. And the other one is to assign 8 colors so that all the 8 lines and every 2 times 2 times 2 block has all the 16, all the 8 colors. And for both of them, so we have a corresponding coloring problem over 16 cells. So that's so all the 8 projections satisfy these conditions. And also, we can consider its variant, reduced one, only to consider 4 orthogonal projections. And further, 64 coloring case, so we have such a solution. But for the 8 color case, so we do not have a solution. But so if we consider only 4 projections, we have this number. And it is so computed with computer. But we want structure behind that. So mathematically formulate such kind of so solution. So so let's consider each block has the same coloring, which is so oriented so with rotations. And the rotations form a Klein's four group, which is an abelian group. And because it is abelian, we can consider its three-dimensional group multiplication table. And it is just the solution of one solution of the Sudoku puzzle, three-dimensional Sudoku puzzle. And further, four-dimensional case, so we, but it is not a four-dimensional solution. And for the four-dimensional case, so we need to consider also reflections. And we consider the reflection group of a cube, so which is order 8, and consider everything as a linear space over the finite group of set field of order 2, and consider all the things so linearly then. Anyway, so we have such a solution, but please look at the paper. And so this is such kind of solution. And yes, finally, so I wonder if this kind of so three-dimensional Sudoku puzzle can be played with pencil puzzle like this. I'm sorry, so this is something so hidden here. Yes, and so with the three-dimensional, four-dimensional conditions, so we have, so even this puzzle has a unique solution. So thank you very much.